currently 11. I was gonna eat and then film the video, but I'm not hungry at the moment, probably because I ate those beans for a snack. So I'll film the video and then I'll eat. So yeah, just setting up my camera shot and gonna be filming a YouTube video for next week. Or this week, I don't know when I'll post it.
Hey guys, and welcome to another video. So today's video, we're gonna talk politics.
So I have lunch, so I have this protein blend, Asian style, steam pressed bird eye thing. I haven't tried it before, but be careful because there's a few of them that look like they may be vegan, but they have milk in it for some really odd reason, probably in the sauce. So I will be making and eating this for lunch, and I will be probably editing the video while I make this. Here is lunch. I'm not sure exactly what's in it, but it has edamame, vegetables, and probably rice or something like that. So yeah, so I'll eat this, and I'm currently almost finished editing the video. I just need to export it. It didn't really take me that long because there's not any fancy edits, or it takes me longer to do what I eat in a day's or day in the lives than it does to do a sit-down video, because there's really, I mean, there's usually one clip, there's two because my camera died. So so I'll be editing and eating, and then I will check up on you later. I'll probably be, I don't know what I'll be doing, but I will check up on you in a little bit. So I'm going to be making some broccoli and cheese soup, but now obviously use soy milk and vegan cheese. We'll be making this. Alrighty, so step one will be cutting up potatoes. So I have four of them right here, and I'll see kind of how much potatoes are actually made, and then I'll kind of go from there. So, potatoes. On two potatoes at this point, and then I'll kind of see, because they're pretty big potatoes, so I'm gonna put the potatoes into the pot. So I got the potatoes. Okay, so we're out of vegetable stock or broth, so I am going to be running to the store, so it'll be a little adventure. Okay, so I am back. So I just ran to all these because it's the closest store that is to me. So I got vegetable cooking stock. I got two of them. I think I only need one for this recipe, but I just got two. And then I also got some mangoes. They were 59 cents each, so I got two of them. And then I got these fruit snacks. These fruit snacks, it doesn't have gelatin in them. Which is really nice because a lot of them do have gelatin, so that is what I got at the store. Alright, so back to soup. So you got chicken stock, you can use broth as well, so you just pour in the container. Vegetable stock, so I don't know why I said chicken. Next up is carrots, so I got these baby carrots, so I'll cut a little bit, some of them up, and put them with the potatoes. I'm gonna put the carrots with the potatoes, and then you bring to a boil, and then cover and let simmer for about 10 minutes. While I do that, I will be making the broccoli, because then you put the broccoli in, and then do another 10 minutes. The next really important part is the broccoli part of the broccoli cheese soup, because, you know, without broccoli is just cheese and potato soup, which honestly doesn't sound too bad either, but I'm making broccoli. So I have one head of broccoli, I think it's called the head, and I will just cut this up.
Okay, so it's been approximately 10 minutes. It's been simmering and stuff. So I've got the potatoes and the carrots in here. So next step would be to put in the broccoli. I might need to add a little bit more vegetable stock, which is really good that I got another container. So I poured in about half of the other container, and I put the broccoli, and I have to cover and simmer for approximately 10 minutes, and I'll make the cheese while I do this. Okay, so for the cheese, you need some butter. So I got this Earth Balance vegan organic whipped buttery spread thing. Some soy milk, I got this True Goodness from Meijer's, and shredded cheese. So I got Follow Your Heart, chewy cheddar, flour. So step one is to melt about 3 tablespoons of butter, which did not take long to do, and then you add flour. Three and a half to 4 cups of milk. So I added soy milk, and then I have to grab a whisk and you whisk it until it's thick. And it usually is not thick, and then like 1 second later it's really thick. So just whisk it. And you can see there's some clumps of the butter and flour mixture in it. So you have to make sure those clumps are out, which will make it thick. Pretty thick. The next step is to add the cheese. So I'm just going to add one bag at a time and then stir it and then add a second bag. So the cheese definitely melts pretty quickly, so that's really good. I use either Follow the Heart or Daya, but Follow the Heart was on sale this week, so I decided why not use the one that was on sale. And I've used Follow the Heart and Daya together. I've never actually used just Follow Your Heart for this recipe, so it's going to be a little interesting. But yeah, it's definitely really good. I've made it a couple times. My non-vegan family, like, eats it up. So, it's really good. So the cheese sauce has melted, so it looks like nacho cheese. What I really want to try is try the pepper jack and do just this and make like a nacho cheese sauce. That would actually be pretty cool. But yeah, so the cheese is melted. It's to put the cheese in the sauce or the soup. And yeah, so it'll thicken when you put it in the fridge. It'll become a lot thicker than it is now. But yeah, broccoli cheddar soup. So I'm gonna eat one of these mangoes as a snack. 30 something. So I'll have a mango. So I went to Culver's and I got a mango lemon ice cooler thing, which is vegan. I got french fries and onion rings. So I got some of the soup that I made earlier, picked up, and then I'm going to have a few of these Gardein meatballs for dinner. Thank you for watching the video. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I'd much appreciate it. You can do that below, and yeah, so I'll see you in another video. Bye!